everybody, Jess here with another episode of Mixed Reviews, the show that collects the biggest reviews from around the net and mixes them into one magical number. And if you're a fan of magical numbers, please hit the like button to keep that magic alive. Now this week we're going to take a look at Mortal Kombat Vita, Fable Heroes, and something that we've never done before on the show, a movie review. Yeah, it's kind of a light week for games, and dude, the freaking Avengers comes out today, and honestly, it just gives me an excuse to talk about the Avengers some more, because it's awesome! But first, the games. Mortal Kombat Vita is a port of last year's 360 and PS3 game. IGN's Stephen Hopper was a big fan. He said that the game offers a ton of features, both old and new, such as a brand new challenge tower that uses the Vita's motion controls and a touchscreen. Stephen also said that the game is a blast to play with great controls and performance. His biggest problem, however, is that the graphics aren't quite as sharp as they were on the consoles, which isn't a big deal when you get right down to it. Now, Stephen gave the game an 8.5 out of 10. The rest of the mix average was really positive, with an 87%. Game Informer gave the game a 9 out of 10. They said that the core gameplay and modes have been perfectly recreated, and that this is the most complete version of Mortal Kombat available. Games Radar wasn't quite as glowing, but still gave it an 8 out of 10. They found that some of the new challenges were annoying, and commented on the visual downgrade from the console version. Still, they said that the Vita version remains faithful to the original game. Overall, the mixed average says that this is a great portable port with a ton of content. Now up next, we have Fable Heroes, a pretty crazy spin-off from the Fable universe. This downloadable game is a four-player brawler with, how shall we say it, a unique art style. I mean, come on guys, just look at it. Unfortunately, IGN's Mitch Dyer said that this game isn't nearly as fun as it looks. He called the game archaic and sterile, with mindless button mashing and abhorrent minigames. He gave the game a 5 out of 10, which counts as mediocre on IGN's scale. The rest of the mix average was meh at a 54%. The most positive review came from the official Xbox magazine with a 7 out of 10. They were a big fan of the family-friendly nature of the game, but admitted that you don't get much for your 10 bucks. On the lowest end was Destructoid with a 3.5. They said that Fable Heroes is a mediocre game at best, with imprecise controls. So the mixed average warns you not to be fooled by the cute characters. You are probably better off skipping this one. Now finally, it's about friggin' time for the Avengers to assemble. Ever since Nick Fury showed up at the ending of Iron Man 1, people have been waiting for Earth's mightiest heroes to grace the big screen, and what a party it is. IGN's Eric Goldman loved this movie and called it a fun, entertaining, and satisfying superhero spectacle. He said that it's the perfect pairing of the perfect cast with the perfect writer-director. His only problem is that Hawkeye is a little underused, but that kind of comes with the territory when you have Captain America, Iron Man, Thor, and the Hulk in the same flick. Eric gave the movie 4.5 out of 5 stars. The mix average was super positive, with an 87%. Now guys, just as a note, we took reviews from a few of the top newspapers and magazines that actually give scores, and mixed them with some of the more geeky sites that love comic book movies, because hey, sometimes you just need that geeky touch. Not that it really mattered, however, because most everyone loves this movie. ComingSoon.net gave it an 8.5 out of 10, saying that while the Avengers isn't going to change any lives, it has successfully fulfilled every Avengers fanboy's dream. Rolling Stone gave the movie 3.5 stars out of 4. They praised the movie's characterization and gave a special nod to Tom Hiddleston, who plays Loki. They ended by saying that they have one word for the Avengers, and that is wowza. And yes, that's a direct quote. So according to our special movie mix average, honestly, why do you need a score? You're gonna go see it anyway. Just remember that it's also the perfect date movie because you have both Chris Hemsworth and Scarlett Johansson. A little something for everyone. And that's it for this edition of Mixed Reviews. Let us know what you thought about us adding a movie review this week in the comments below. And before I leave you, I wanted to let you guys know that IGN's awesome new app just hit the Xbox 360. Download it from Xbox Live Marketplace and you'll get free access to a ton of IGN video content, including more videos of yours truly. And also check it out because, well, it's free. I'm Jessica Chobot and we'll mix it up again next week.